إنه كان غفارا ويرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا. What is Nabi saying? فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ Make istighfar to your Rabb. What is istighfar? Two words. Tawbah is to turn towards Allah. How do you turn towards Allah? By istighfar. By owning up your sins. By making istighfar, by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. Tawbah is to turn towards Allah. Istighfar is the way in which we turn towards Allah. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. We have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ ذُنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah says, do not despair of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive every single sin. Everything. Allah will forgive shirk, Allah will forgive kufr, Allah will forgive everything provided we make tawbah. Which brings us to the final issue of the shurut, of the shart, of the conditions of tawbah, and there are three. The first condition of tawbah is genuine regret in the heart. To be genuinely contrite, to be genuinely ashamed, and to be genuinely regretful that I committed this sin. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a person who is a muttaqi, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all among the muttaqun. He said, a muttaqi, if he commits the smallest sin, it sits on top of him like a rock. He feels that this is a huge burden, a rock that is going to fall on my head at any minute and crush me. So obviously if this burden is on my head, what do I want to do? I want to get rid of it. How do I do that? Immediately I make tawbah. Smallest thing, whatever it was. And he said, a person who has no taqwa, what does he do? How does he treat sin? He said, he treats sin like a fly that is sitting on his nose. He feels that at any moment I can just move my hand and the fly will fly away. There is no fear in his heart because I have committed this sin, because I have transgressed against the order and ahkam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a sign. Not to have this fear is a sign of lack of taqwa. So the first condition of the acceptance of tawbah is genuine regret in the heart. Where a person stands before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cries and says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, forgive me, this is nothing which I did and I ask your forgiveness. Genuine regret. Number two condition is never to go back to that thing again. Not a question of, you know, doing something wrong and then again doing it wrong and continuously. No. If you are genuinely regretful, then you do not repeat that mistake. So never to go back to that again. And third condition of tawbah is if the mistake was of a nature, which is from the hukuk al-ibad, if it was from a nature where the transgression was against somebody else, against a person, then a third condition is required, which is you make up whatever oppression that you did. You undo that thing which you did. For example, if you swallowed somebody's property, then you regurgitate it, give it back to him. If you malign somebody's name and you gave him a bad name by doing riba or qatan or whatever it was, you go and apologize and you stand up and say, I'm sorry, I made this wrong comment about so and so, actually that is not true and I'm the one at fault. Is it easy to do? No. But it is easy to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he asked in the famous hadith, he asked the Sahaba, he said, do you know who are the destitute of this ummah? Who are the poor, the destitute? They have nothing. They said, Ya Rasulullah, the destitute of the ummah, the people who have no dirham or dinar. He said, no. He said, the destitute of this ummah are those who will come before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with hasanat, with good deeds, the size of the mountain of Uhud. And when they are standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all this hajj and umrah and khairat and sadaqat fi sabilillah and salawat and tahajjud and rizam and tilawatul Quran and azkar and whatever,
Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when they are standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those they wronged in the world, the people whose haqq they took in the world, the people who they harmed and maligned and whatever they did in the world, they would come and there will be a long line. And then it will be asked to them, what do you want? And they will say, Ya Rab, give us justice. And what is the dirham and dinar? What is the currency of the jannah, of the akhirah? The currency of the akhirah is not the dollar and pound. The currency of the akhirah is deeds, his actions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them, what do you want me to do? And they will say, Ya Rab, give us those good deeds that he has brought, because he harmed us in the dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let this be done. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a time will come when that entire mountain of Uhud of good deeds will disappear and there will be nothing left. And he said, however, the line of people that they wronged will still be there. Will still be there. Then Allah will say, now what do you want me to do? They will say, Ya Rab, give our bad deeds to that person, because now he has nothing to give us. Take away our bad deeds and give it to him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this will be done. And that person who came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a mountain of good will be thrown into the hellfire because of the bad deeds of the other. Now you might say, how is it possible to have such a long line of people who will never finish? And I tell you, in today's modern world, it's very easy. One email is all you require. One single email maligning somebody, the only eternal thing in this world is email. One single email maligning somebody will go and rotate on the internet for 1,000 years, long before after you have gone into your cover, and it will keep on earning you punishment because of what you wrote about somebody else, which was false. So it's very easy to understand this. Not difficult at all in today's modern world. How is it possible to get a line of people who you have harmed from here to Timbuktu? Very simple, right? One email. I remind myself that let us make sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should forgive all our sins. We ask Allah, we make tawbah, we clean our slate before we go before Him. Because once we go before Him, there is no cleaning of any slate. The cleaning has to be done in this dunya. So let us make hisab. My request to you is, today when you go back home, sit down with a sheet of paper and write down all the ways, all the things that you need to make tawbah for. The rights of Allah and the rights of people, your brothers and sisters and so on and so forth. We have families who are split apart on issues of one small piece of land, one small ground, one house, one something, inheritance. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. We forget that no matter how much you have, even if you own the whole world, you are still going into a hole in the ground when you die. And you want to split a family, you want to bring problem between brother and brother because of a small piece of land somewhere or a house or something. How terrible are you going? How can Muslims behave like this? Think about it. But huge law practices survive because thanks to the cases of one Muslim against another Muslim. The lawyers make dua every day, Allah keep this, because this is how I eat. We make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put love of each other in our heart. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it possible for us, when we leave this masjid, to go and cancel all those cases. Go to your brother, hug your brother, kiss your brother, give him the paper for the land and the house and say, keep it alhamdulillah with my blessing and my dua. Because you as a brother is more important to me than this piece of ground. Take it and make dua for me, inshallah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who does that, I will guarantee him a palace min wasatil jannah, in the center of jannah. So if you believe the word of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go and do it now. Immediately after, you must go and cancel all those cases and cancel all the sacred offices, stuff from the heart. Throw it away, clean your heart. Go and hug your brother, hug your sister. Go and kiss them and tell them your family is important. And that on the basis of this, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that palace in the Jannah. Yeah? I always say, every Muslim must be in the real estate business. Anyone comes and says, what do you do? If I am in the real estate business. So what is the real estate business? I am making palaces in Jannah. My job is, my business is, I make palace in the Jannah. Alhamdulillah. Every Muslim must be in the real estate business. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of you real estate tycoons with hundreds of thousands of palaces in the Jannah, inshallah.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك واشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك اللهم ونتوب اليك. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.